I think this is the same shade the C63's come in, but it's weird to see it on a G-Wagon. Looks pretty flex. Red on red interior. You guys ever see this? And this has a E36 M3 motor in it. He was nice enough to let me borrow his G63 2018. Pretty dope car. We're in it right now. I'm headed actually to go meet up with my boy Sean. He also has a YouTube channel called Track Day TV. Make sure you go check it out. I'll put the link in the description. But yeah, I'm gonna meet up with him. We'll talk about the G-Wagon. Do a little review on this car, you know? Yeah, let's get started. So right off the bat, I mean, as you can see, the interior is just phenomenal. Now we've done the review on the G350, which is pretty similar. But in the G63, this whole screen is standard, where in the G350, the digital dash is actually an option. And so is sunroof as an option as well in the G350. But in 63, obviously, you get a lot of standard features. Right off the bat, you know, driving 63s with the 463, I guess, the previous models, or the G55s. I must say, this is way more comfortable compared to the other one. I kind of like it. It still has, like, Mercedes still managed that rugged off-road feel, that, you know, that rough bad boy feel of the whole G-Wagon itself. But me personally, I prefer the 55 because that V8 grumble, you know, it's a bigger motor. Obviously this comes with the 4.0 V8, making about 580 horsepower, which is a lot, you know, a lot of torque as well. Same motor used in the C63, same motor used in the E63 as well, and throughout, you know, the previous model, the 63, had the bigger 5-liter motor, twin turbo as well. This is a twin turbo, but like I said, it's a 4-liter V8, small, torquey, less lag compared to the other 63. I still prefer the 55, and that instant torque from the supercharged motor is phenomenal. But like I said, interior wise, this thing takes the cake, man. Nothing like it. And he's got the upgraded performance steering wheel as well, so it's pretty cool. And he's got the carbon fiber everywhere with the brushed aluminum and the piano black. And yeah, like I said, very similar to the G350 review we did. And so the infotainment system is very similar to the G350 that we saw. I'll put the link in the description so you guys can go check it out. Unfortunately, this doesn't have the massaging seats, which are, you know, the active bolsters and everything, the active seats that you get in the AMG cars. And it also doesn't have the massaging seats because this is one of the first models that he got. When he first got it, there was actually a premium on the pricing because that was when the European norms were going from Euro 4 to Euro 5, and there was a delay in production, and these things were selling for a premium. I mean, he had a straight up key to key deal with a little money on top for a Urus, or Urus, however you want to say it, and he turned it down. Yeah, man, he kept the G, and it's such a dope car. I'm glad he did. Urus, pretty dope. I mean, obviously, it's a Urus, it's a Lambo truck. Definitely has its cool factor, but the G-Wagon definitely has its own swag and clout as well. Yeah, let's talk about performance. Now, this thing has many modes. It has, you know, individual. Actually, let me show you guys. You know, this is kind of unsafe, but yeah. All right, so we got it. So this is like this. We got a slippery mode. It's got individual. You can, like, adjust it how you want it. And it tells you what all the, you know, custom settings are. Then you have your comfort, you know, Sport, and your Sport Plus. As you can see, it's just downshift, the exhaust gets louder, and all that good stuff. So let's just go back to comfort, because I'm not trying to get in any trouble right now before I meet my boy. I think we're probably gonna get in trouble later for all the ruckus we caused. But both the G-Wagons, by the way, I don't know if I mentioned, but he also has a G-Wagon. This is a blue one, and he has a red one, so we're gonna be rolling Pepsi, if you know what I mean. Got the red and blue, you know? We just need a white one, then we got the American flag. Anyways, yeah, just heading up to meet my boy Sean. Like I said, he has a few cars. He just got rid of his supercharged E92 M3. He has an F-Pace SVR and the G63. And we're actually going to go head over to New Jersey from Philly because he wants to get a PDR, paintless dent removal, done on his car. He has a small dent that he wants to get rid of. So, yeah, going to meet up with him. Hopefully get a car wash because he said he needs a wash. I need a wash. We need to get some fuel as well. So, yeah, this thing's a gas guzzler, as you can see, this thing. The moment you step on it, it just drops down. So, yeah, I've been dealing with that, but, you know, can't have your cake and eat it too. I think Mercedes should release an all-electric G-Wagon. What do you guys think? I mean, just for shits and giggles, you know? Believe it or not, there's actually a four-cylinder variant for the G-Wagon in China, I think. That's what I heard. I don't know if it's actually going to happen. I heard on CarWow, Matt Watson, he mentioned that there's going to be a four-cylinder G-Wagon, so that's going to be funny. Yeah, whoever wants to sell, save gas and do good for the environment. I don't know if it's a petrol or a diesel motor, but yeah. So anyways, on our way now. So we'll just cut to the B-roll. Alright, let's do this tunnel run. Gonna throw it in Sports Plus. So as you can see, my buddy Sean just pulled up. He got a little dent on his bumper. He backed into his Ford Raptor. So we're about to go to Jersey and take care of that. Got the custom number plate, SRP, that's what's up. So yeah, pretty cool shade, huh? I think this is the same shade the C63 is coming, but it's weird to see it on a G-Wagon. Looks pretty flex on the G. Looks pretty cool. So we're rolling deep with the G's. Let's get it. Sean here from Track Day TV.
What's up, guys?
Want to check out his G-Wagon.
My 1063.
Red on red interior. You guys ever see this? I ain't got this in Mumbai yet. Shit's hot. So, Sean's buddy has an E30, and this has a E36 M3 motor in it, S52, manual, super clean. Damn, check it out. That's so cool, man. Check it out, manual gearbox, custom steering wheel, quick release. He's got a shift knob from an E36 M3, I'm not sure, but it seems pretty modern. Seems like it's from an E46 or something. But it's a 5-speed. E46 M3s are 6-speed.
This is clean.
He's got an M gauge cluster too.
Yeah, shit's on. I like this.
Yeah, that's OEM. All 90s cars or 80s cars.
Check button.
So Sean got his little dent out. I mean, you can't even notice it. He couldn't even notice it before, but he's real anal when it comes to his car. So just doing a fuel stop, you know, filling up the G's. It's gonna be a long time because these things got big tanks and they're real thirsty. So yeah, getting gassed up. Done filling up. Let's go. Hop in the G. From the other G to this G. Oh God. It's a task to get into this thing. So high up. I can just imagine if you had a 6x6 or like a 4x4 square. It's insane. One thing I do gotta mention though, this got that lane departure thing, so as soon as you get closer to the lines, it senses it and gives you a slight vibration in the steering wheel. You would think the bounce is off on your wheels or your car needs an alignment or something. It's really annoying, and if you get real close, it like jerks it back. So you gotta press and hold this over here, and then it goes away, and then, yeah. But in case you're a sleepy person and you're driving, and you know, it's a good thing to have, just in case, you know, so you don't drift off and crash your G63 or your whatever, Mercedes. Good feature to have. I wish this car did have heated steering wheel though, but I guess because of the carbon fiber and stuff, you can't, and obviously Alcantara and suede. Damn, this, the Cardinal Red. Hastened Cardinal Red or whatever that paint's called is sick. And I love the red interior. Red on red. Even the people at Mercedes were like, "You sure you want red on red?" And he's like, "Yeah, I'm good with it. Let me get it." And it came out great. I mean, great. I've never seen it before. Definitely flex. Good job, Sean. Finally got up to the car wash place. Tight squeeze here. But we good. Hand car wash. Got the Mexican cartel out here, dog. Got the boys hard at work getting that wash. So we out here in the hood. Sean got me in the hood washing the car. Got the car wash done. I helped with my boy Sean as well. Chilled with him. It was a good time kicking it with them. Make sure you guys go check out his channel, Track Day TV. Yeah, I'm Sean. Thanks for introducing me to a good car wash spot. Really good. So if you're in South Philly, hit him up. King's Detail. King's HW Detail on Instagram. Yeah, fun day. Out with the G's. Everyone was looking. Like, got some crazy reactions. Yeah, right now we're just heading back to my neck of the woods, Northeast Philadelphia. You know? So, and there's a good, nice tunnel coming up. So, yeah, let's go ahead and put it in race or sport plus. Yeah, sounds so good. And welcome back. A beautiful day here in Philadelphia, PA. Got the G-Wagon looking all nice and clean. Unfortunately, yesterday, once we got it clean, it was nighttime. You know, you couldn't see anything, but look how nice this looks once it's all clean. And yeah, I do stay on the main road, close to the main road. So you'll hear cars throughout this part of the video. So yeah, went ahead and painted the calipers orange, as you can see, because he owns a gym actually called Orange Theory Fitness. Go ahead and check them out. By the way, we do have a branch in Mumbai. It's called Orange Theory Fitness. Chem's Corner. I'll put the link in the description. Make sure you go check it out. I'm gonna go there soon, guys. I promise you. I need to stop slacking, and I'm gonna head over. The only thing is, it's on the other side of the town because I live in Andheri, and that's in town in Chem's Corner. So yeah. So yeah. Let's talk about the new 464 G63. All right. So let's start out with the key. New Mercedes key, like how they have it on the E class and the C class and the S class. Yeah. As you can see, it's got the AMG logo, and it does not have keyless entry, obviously, because doesn't have keyless entry because you got your traditional lock over here. You can hear that sound. Mirrors opening up. You can hear that sound. You see the lock opening, close. But how cool is that? And once you open it up, as you can see, you're welcome with this beautiful blue on blue interior. It's not exactly the same color as the exterior, but can't complain. And I'm kind of glad it's not the same color, because then it'll be too much, you know. Yesterday we see my buddy's car red on red. That was hot, but you know, it could be a little too much. But actually, you know what, I liked it. It was nice and subtle. Beautiful interior, as you're welcomed. Let's talk about the outside. We already spoke about the inside. Before we go outside, I must show you guys the Burmester surround sound is A1 in here. It's so good. They have a subwoofer in the back too that's exposed. I'm gonna show you guys in a bit. Oh, gotta love that sound. So in the back, of course, we're greeted with the hatch, or I don't know what you guys call it, a door. So sorry, the car's kind of messy, but yeah, here's that Burmester surround sound woofer or subwoofer, which is pretty cool, and it thumps pretty hard. We got, you know, for the cargo, we got this provision here, which he's probably put it at home, but we got a 115 volt charger back here, as you can see with the plugs. The previous G-Wagon didn't have that. How cool is that? Pretty big boot, can't complain. And obviously, this doesn't open up because the spare tire's in the back, guys. I don't know if you guys know, but the spare tire's in the back. And believe it or not, it's not the spare tire from this car. It's actually a spare tire from a G550. I don't know if you can see it. Actually, you know what? We can just, yeah. It's not the same wheel exactly. It's a different wheel. I think it's from a G550 or G500 or something. I don't know why Mercedes did that. I guess because they couldn't fit a 22 inch wheel on the back. That would just take the whole, vision up, I guess, and probably make the door heavier. So yeah. And of course, they still left it with the side exit exhaust, which sounds pretty good. Like I was saying, the 22 inch wheels by Pirelli Scorpion P0s, or Scorpion Zeros, or whatever you want to call it. V8 bi-turbo badge, obviously. Believe it or not, these actually reflectors over here, this is orange, and the one in the back is red. But he went ahead and wrapped it gloss black, so it all looks like one same piece, which is pretty cool. Let's go to the passenger side. I love that sound when you open the door. Yeah, you got your oh shit handlebar over here, like every G-Wagon comes with, and they still maintain that. So yeah, and it's got a little carbon fiber touch over here. Man, I just love this interior. If you could give me a G55 with this interior, it would be like the ultimate G-Wagon for me, because although this car is fast and it drives amazing, it's probably more fuel efficient and better for the environment, I still like my V8 supercharged, man. There's just something about it. I love that old school ruggedness feel. Maybe that's just me. Comment below what you guys think. If you've driven a G55 before and you're driving one of these before, tell me what you think is better. I mean, I feel like the G55 is a little more raw. It has a little more soul. But I feel like the G63 is a little more refined, or a lot more refined. Let me know what you guys think. Here we are, G-Wagon. Cold start. Let's see what it sounds like. And of course, you got your push to start and your auto off and on, which is really annoying. I wish you could like program it. I know you can through coding. You can program it permanently stay off, and you know, you don't have to deal with it coming on and off. It's just by default will be off when you start the car. But yeah, anyways, cold start, here we go. Sorry guys. Let's go ahead and open up the exhaust. You hear that, guys? The valves are shut. Is dope. I've never heard it so prominent on a car. Like, I guess it's so prominent and loud because it's like right there. The exhaust is like right below you. So yeah, man, I'm really getting used to this. I'm loving it. I just shut the door and it didn't shut properly. Yo, by the way, I forgot to mention to you guys, check this out. On all the new G63s or all the new G-Wagons, you guys hear that in the background? I hear all these cars every time when I'm driving, when I'm outside or in my house, in my room. That's my room over there, by the way, right there. That's my room. That's what, this is one of the houses where I grew up in. As I was saying, this is my house. This is where I stay in Philadelphia. This ain't the hood. This is like Little Russia. A lot of Russians, Armenians, Georgians stay over here. So if you guys are wondering why I used to have, or why I have Russian license plates in my cars, that's why, because it's like an inside joke. It started as an inside joke with my friends, and it just ended up looking so good, and I just left it, you know. I was just like, f*** it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that little review of the G63. A lot more to come up in my America trip, so stay tuned, and I'll see you guys soon.